Welcome, driver. Today you'll be performing some shunting duties around the docks. To start, please couple up to the wagons in Western Breakwater 4. Be aware you'll need to manually adjust all points. So this is from bite-sized scenarios, which I've noticed there's a bunch of stuff come up from bite-sized scenarios. And they all seem to be around the half an hour mark, so I guess bite-sized scenarios is sort of living up to his name. So yeah, interesting. Go and have a look at some of the stuff that they're uploading. People making shorter scenarios is less often. Give them some support. Running two from quite some time. This is the first one. And we're doing one on New Jersey later on. I saw that comment that it was that people thought Dirt Rally was more of a sim than Dirt 4. And the comments that I saw were, if you're not very good at driving, then Dirt 4 might be better. Whereas Dirt Rally is more of a sim if you're better at driving. So I kept on with Dirt 4. We've all seen that. But Dirt Rally 2 is coming. Right, take these wagons to Dockyard 17, ensuring all the wagons have passed the points before you stop. Where is Dockyard 17? And swing that one round. That's it. Now we clear path to Dockyard 17. Well, you know what, I got Dirt 4 cheap, so I thought I'd have a look, see how I got on with it, and then if Dirt Rally, when Dirt Rally 2 comes out, we'll maybe play some Dirt Rally 2. tell, I think, but it's basically what it's originally based on an 060 tank engine. This is based on early steam designs. Yeah, this is Falmouth branch, yeah, down in the dockyards. Main line up there. Another Gronk in the main line. It is too. There you go, Moggy. Just for you. That's almost a model railway curve, that's so tight. Yeah, I thought you'd like to see the Grog. I know you haven't seen one in a while. Grogs are diesel electric, Jeff. So it is a traction motor. Yeah, I think so, Jeff, yeah. Falmouth Exchange 1, going up there. That one out the side. A couple of wagons run around them via Exchange 2. Train track traffic. It may have been a cost in the back at the time, but it was back in the early days of diesel traction, so it might have seemed extravagant and unnecessary to have three traction motors. Around via Falmouth Exchange 2, a couple of the other ends. You know, from days with MSDS, the idea of front coupling still worries me. Does that bother you at all, Moggy? That impending fear that when I do the front couple, it won't crash. I mean, it's not an issue with this, but with MSDS, almost every front couple of them crashed because it's light. 09 was essentially the same as an 08, but it was geared differently. So the 09 had a faster top speed, but not quite as much. Whereas the 08 could pull more, but couldn't go as fast. See that, TJSP? Right, let's pull these wagons to Falmouth Approach 3. To be honest, Jeff, I'm only remembering to uncouple these because you mentioned it. These things, on the circular things on the back here, they're called buffers. They're basically spring-loaded. You can see they've got the silver piston. Greasy with a metallic taste. Push the wagons into Falmouth Siding 1. Oh, 166. Yeah, in America you don't need buffers because your knuckle couplers have the same effect, Jeff, whereas here we use three-link and stanter and all sorts of types of coupling things. Which are just basically, think of it as being three links in the chain. So the flow about to use the buffers to effectively manage the spring between. Yeah, modern motors, they generally don't have buffers. So Mark from Coates from HST buffers. Good evening, Simi Kane, how are you doing? Yeah, pretty much everything in the US uses knuckles. Right, let's drive from the siding 3, which couples to empty. British Rail headlights basically didn't light anything up. They would be used in either they wouldn't be used at night or they would be used in a lit yard. Or rather just as a torch. Welcome to the UK, don't forget to set your watch back close. Falmouth Exchange 1, where you uncouple, run round them, and apparently. So, go to Exchange 1, which is that one. Go to Exchange 1, then we're going to run round, pull them in, push them in. So they can push them into a side. Hey Alex, very good, thank you. Spent far too much watching Netflix, but voice being drowned out by the game sounds. Let me have a look. Possibly, yeah. Turn the game down. A bit. Sorry, Moggy. My voice up a bit. Sorry, Moggy. Is that better?
Sorry, Moggy.
Boy! On the 1 in 38. I mean, who did it just a siding like this on a 1 in 38? Who thought that was a good idea when they were designing this railway? I'll make sure we're all the way in and we won't foul on the other end. Wagons,
hey?
You want about that? A load of rubbish. Hopefully it'll hang there and it's 1 in 38 grading all on its own by magic. Right, I'm coming from the wagons, run around to the other end of the rake fire exchange. Do! Yeah, I saw the little Rust and Hornsby one, yeah. See you later, Jeff. Right. Let us flip that over. Flip that over. We're going to be going to Breakwater 2, which is over there. So let us swing that one round. That one. That one. That one. Second road. Which is that one. Good to go! Yeah, Cameron was showing me a video of the flirts running up and down at this. So I think he's excited to try and spot one at some point. Right, into Breakwater 2. Hey there, Red Devil Dom, how's it going? We are going to break water too. Yes, I'm looking at going to this crew event. Looks like a really nice collection of stock they're going to have there. I thought maybe it'd be nice to have another meetup. I'm doing good, thank you, Red Double Dom. Oh, look at that cheeky little Freightliner 08 sitting there, interloping. Thought we could steal some business. No, it's not the DRS open day. I can't remember what it's called. It's the beginning of June, Crucible. It just came up on my Facebook the other day. I think Locomotive Services are going to have a bunch of stuff there. Stop and paint it orange. Virgin are going to have stuff there. I think it seemed like there was a lot of everything going to be there. It's a bit of an event. Adding them to these ones that were already loaded. How was Dovetail last week when my first week back? It's good actually. It's good to be back. Enjoying the new office as well. Absolutely fantastic. Yep, the APT's a crew, yep. Alright, we need to go to Dockyard 26. Crew Diesel Depot Charity Open Day, June the 8th. +30 steam diesel and electric exhibits lined up for a charity open day on June the 8th at the former Crew Diesel Depot, now the operational base of Locomotive Services Limited. It's nearby Red Double Dom, so we were near the dockyard before, just outside it. And this one it's in the fitted rigging house inside the dockyard. Much bigger, room to grow. Right. Yeah, I've been to the RNI Museum Baked Bean Kit. I had a good look around the dockyard because we were on the dockyard before in the joiner's shop. It's very good. really well worth a visit. There, and that's it straight through. There's a load of newly imported tractors at Eastern Breakwater 1. You must couple to the wagons containing them and move them to Falmouth Siding 2. There's a Gronkatunity muggy. Steam exhibits are likely to include 70,000 Britannia, Royal Scott, 46100, Black Five, 4531, West Country, Braunton, locomotive, home diesel fleet of locomotives, including a Class 08, 37, various Class 47s, and a Class 55 will be on display alongside the bubble car and other LSL exhibits. Both fleets, including a Class 390 pending email and Class 221 Super Voyager, converging the trains west coast, will also be present. The event is being organised by Virgin Train staff based at Crewe Station. So, and it supports charity. So, can't be bad. 5,000 tickets limit as well, so. I don't know when the tickets open up. Oh, I think someone told me, Adam told me it was at the beginning. It was February 6th, there you go. Tickets for the Open Day will be on sale online and by phone from February 6th. Come on, Gronky, you've got to share the Gronk. It does, I thought it sounded really good when I saw the notice for it, JP. It's like, ooh, possible meetup opportunity. And definite opportunity to see lots of trains. Crew might be a bit far. Yeah, it's on the other side of the country, isn't it? All the wagons to approach 3. Where is approach 3? All the way back to there. Go around that bit. Pull them all the way back. To approach 3. Clear them all the way through. Well, hopefully, Red Double Dom. Hopefully. Things are certainly going well. Keep up the momentum, keep putting out releases that people are enjoying. Inaccurate Marksman, thank you very much for the resub, 5th month, very much appreciated. Yeah, well, you don't want to get the green tractors, you want to get the red ones because they're massively cheaper. No. So an update went out for TSW today. Yes, indeedy. Did the release not? No, it's not got out for it yet. If not, then I'll probably back to one. It's not a major update, but it's a good one, worth having. I think it fixes some crashes that were introduced. Tractors bound for Nebworth Farms. Not at the moment, Danderman. I need to get back to doing that, but I have been doing some, but not tonight. Mostly because I've forgotten, almost. They are still there to work through them. Lighter than those ballast wagons, I'll say that for them. Might have to try anywhere near as hard to get these up. Oh yes, the major one probably for most people is the blinking bonnet of the 45 has gone. I'm sure this has been more than half an hour. Okay. It's the last move, yes, it is good. Put those over there. That one and change that one. Puts them over there. No, I need to kind of have a look at Bossman's Facebook. Right, push the wagons into siding two and uncouple. £28 return. That's not bad, Rocky. Ooh, they're looking at a night photo shoot, possibly. Wow. The real train drivers drive from the rear of the train to cast their signals. Someone has to spot for them, so you'd have someone else out looking at them, looking at what's going on and communicating via radio. You're part of a team on the railway, you're not an individual. I know, but you deserve better than Moggy class, Moggy. Come on, treat yourself to at least third. Right, great job. Your shunting duties are finished. All you need to do is park your train dockyard 27. Hand signals and whistles. One whistle followed by a scream and a yell means you probably should stop in a fairly decent time. Kirkway. Right, head to Dockyard 27 where you can sign off. Lovely bit of shunting, isn't it, Simuko? Rather enjoyed that myself, actually. Shunting makes your teeth itch. I don't think this next one is shunting, though, Baked Bean, so you're alright. Well done, you completed the scenario. Be sure to check out more runs from bite-sized scenarios.